Hello, Tom Joyner.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. I'm healthy.
Yes, you are. You are a healthy fella. And we are going to be talking about health and talking about the coronavirus, as well as the vaccine that is now available to everyone in this country. And I want to talk about that as it relates to our comings and goings, Tom, and especially as we get ready for a very special event come November. That would be the Tom Joyner Foundation Fantastic Voyage.
Yes.
We are anticipating a flawless voyage, and to help us and to spread the word about the vaccines and to move forward, as we are just encouraging everyone to be as healthy as they possibly can be during this coronavirus issue. We want to welcome in America's doctor. Dr. Anthony Fauci is the world-renowned physician and immunologist. He is also the director of the U.S. National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases, and he is the chief medical advisor to the man we like to call President Joe Biden. Welcome in, Dr. Fauci.
Thank you very much, Sybil. Thank you, Tom. Good to be with you guys.
Yeah.
It is great to have you here. Dr. Fauci, I just got to tell you right off the bat, I am a big fan of yours. And in my own geeky way, I have admired your efforts over the years. And I thank you for all that you have done to keep America safe and healthy, and as well as informed, which is what we like to do. And I have a newsletter. It's called the What You Need to Know newsletter. It's a Monday through Friday newsletter. And I promise you, for the last 15 to 16 months, every day, we have devoted a section of our newsletter to the coronavirus and updating it. And your name is usually mentioned about once a day in our newsletter. So I want to thank you for that. And also, if you are of a mind, we'd love to have you on talking about the updates. But we are here today to talk about this particular day and asking you, can you tell us and tell our audience what advice are you giving to our audience? What efforts this administration is taking to ensure the communities of color have access to the vaccine?
Well, Sybil, that's a very important question and something that we take very, very seriously, because people of color, for a number of reasons, both for the jobs they generally find themselves in, where they're essential members of society, they're out there in the trenches doing the kinds of jobs that need to be done, which in the first place puts them at a higher risk of getting infected when there is a lot of viral dynamics in society. Secondly, brown and black people, particularly African Americans, have a higher incidence and prevalence of underlying medical conditions, which, if they do get infected with SARS-CoV-2 and develop COVID-19, there's a greater likelihood compared to the general population that they will get a severe outcome. And that's the reason why, on a population basis, it is more likely that brown and black people will be hospitalized if they get infected and will actually die. And that is a clear fact. So what are you going to do about that? You do about that is you want to make sure that brown and black people have access, ready and easy access, to getting to the life-saving intervention to prevent them from getting infected, and that's a vaccine. So what's being done is there's very active outreach to answer the questions of brown and black people who may have some questions that they really want answered before they go and get vaccinated. Reasonable questions. The other thing is to make it as easy as possible to get vaccinated. And that means having vaccine community centers all throughout the areas that are particularly in demographic areas that are highly represented by minority populations, to get vaccines in pharmacies that are within the easy reach of African-American and other brown and black populations, to also have mobile units that go out into the community and make it available to them. Anything that we possibly can do to make it extremely easy to get people vaccinated, because we really want to protect everyone, particularly those who have a greater vulnerability. And it's just a matter of fact of life that brown and black people, when they do get infected, which they do more often in the general population, that they have those kinds of comorbidities that they need the protection of a vaccine. So we're pulling out all the stops because we care about everyone. We want to make sure that all of the people in this country and throughout the world have the benefit of a good intervention, and that's a vaccine. That's
Dr. Fauci, I have a question.
Sure.
Do you know what percentage of the African-American community is fully vaccinated?
You know, it's probably less than the general average of the white population. You know, it's very interesting. If you look at the elderly Black population, they're doing almost as well as anybody else. It's the younger group that we need to get to.
What about gender, male, female?
You know, female generally more than male. That's generally the situation when you come to interventions. We want to get everybody, Tom. We want to get male, female, young, old. We know that there is a disparity. And the disparity sometimes is related to people needing more information before they make the decision.
How much more information do we need?
Well, you asked
everybody. Everybody knows,
right? Yeah, that's the reason why. You know, Tom, you bring out a good point. That's the reason why we need to get trusted messengers like yourselves to get the message out. I think you inadvertently hit the nail right on the head when you said it. How much information do you need?
How much more, right?
How much more?
You know, coming from a person who is not a member of the brown and Black community, no matter who I am.
Would you consider yourself honorary?
I would do. I want to be an honorary member of the brown and Black community. Absolutely. Absolutely. But the thing is, you want trusted messengers at the community level, which is the reason why people like myself and my colleagues in the public health arena, anytime we get asked if it's possible, we get out there and want to talk in media that are the media that brown and Black people follow the most. And that's why I'm talking to you guys.
Well, Tom, let me turn this to you, because we know how this pandemic and the quarantine has affected you, because you love to be out there amongst your fans, amongst your listeners of the radio show. So you talk to the people and tell them how getting the vaccine has affected you and your life.
I have. But still, even people as close to me that work with me on a daily basis keep saying to me, I'm not sure yet. I got to do some more research. Well, how much more research are you going to do? I mean, all the information is out there, but we don't want to believe it. We don't want to believe what's out there. And I don't know how to overcome that.
Well, you know, there are a couple of reasons why, well, more than a couple, why people don't get vaccinated, but let's just restrict it to the demographic group we're talking about now, brown and Black people. So there is what's called disinformation, myths about it that are just patently untrue, such as I hear things like there's a chip in the vaccine, you stick it in your arm and it'll track you, or it'll make you magnetic. I didn't even know about that until I heard it, like, it'll stick your arm to the refrigerator or something. Or it will make you sterile. You won't be able to have children. All of that is nonsense. And the way that you counter mis or disinformation is by continuing to push the envelope about getting the correct information out. And that's where it gets to the point of the trusted messages doing that. But also, give them the facts. Tom, you hit the nail on the head. There have been hundreds of millions of doses that have been given. In the real world effectiveness, it is highly, highly effective. We have multiple studies, not only from the United States, from other countries, completely different, from the UK, from Israel, from Qatar, from places around the world that have vaccines. We as a nation are very fortunate that we have as much vaccine as we need to vaccinate everyone.
Mm-hmm.
It would be a terrible shame that we have the ability to prevent suffering and death, and we don't utilize it because of misinformation, disinformation, or just for reasons that people can't explain, they don't want to get vaccinated. We've got to continue to push the envelope with the right message of why it's important. You know, you might even, and I think it's important to take the tact that it's not only about you, because often young people say, well, the chances of my getting a serious outcome because right. I'm young and healthy is so low, why do I need a vaccination? Well, here's the facts. Even though, relatively speaking, compared to the elderly and those with underlying conditions, with the new Delta variant, which is more infectious, easily transmittable than the standard SARS-CoV-2, it can give more severe disease. We're starting to see more and more young people mm-hmm. get serious outcomes.
And what's that age range, doctor, that you're talking about younger people?
You know, we're talking about people in their late teens, early 20s, 30s, mm-hmm. people like that, who generally do really quite well.
Yeah.
There's also a syndrome called long COVID, Sybil, which means that even if you get infected and get very few symptoms at all, you could have the persistence of these unexplainable, sometimes incapacitated things like fatigue, like inability to concentrate. So for your own safety, but there's something else that I believe we can get younger people hopefully to relate to, that let's say you're young and you don't get vaccinated, but you do get infected, but you don't get any symptoms.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't end with you, because even though you don't get any symptoms, it's entirely conceivable that you will inadvertently or innocently pass it on to someone else who might get a serious outcome. That could be a loved family member, that could be a friend, or that can be somebody that you never even met before. I don't think anybody would want to deliberately be in a situation where they passed an infection on to someone else that was very harmful to them. So you've got to appeal not only to your own safety, but to your responsibility to your community.
And that seems to be what would be the president's specific mandate to the country via you and our conversations about doing what's best, not only for ourselves, but for the general community as a whole.
That is absolutely the case. This is a devastating pandemic that's a global pandemic. We are all in this together.
Yeah.
We have a common enemy. Unfortunately, there's a lot of divisiveness in our country where people, for one reason or other, sometimes even politically motivated, don't want to get vaccinated or don't want to do this. We need to put that aside. We're dealing with a historic pandemic, the likes of which we haven't seen in over 100 years. If ever there was a time to pull together as a country, it's now. That's what we're talking about. Let science guide what we do, not any other extraneous reasons for things. Let science and evidence and data dictate what we do.
I got to tell you, doctor, I obviously didn't have a choice in the vaccine that I was given, but I'm really glad to report that I was given the Moderna vaccine, and the role that Dr. Kazmekia Corbett played in the creation of this vaccine. And it was also really heartwarming, and it instilled a great deal of strength in me to see the Black women that stepped up to be the first people to take the vaccines.
Absolutely. No, you bring a very good point. I think the idea, and I'm glad you brought it up, you know, because Mikia Corbett works in my institute, in my vaccine research center. She is a model of scientific accomplishment, of someone who speaks out the truth, and she's out there trying her best to get her brothers and sisters to get vaccinated. So the African-American community should feel proud that one of the most important people involved in the development of this vaccine is a young, dynamic, African-American scientists.
Yeah. Well, Dr. Fauci, I want to thank you so much for your time. Just on the very slim chance that you and your lovely wife, as well as your adult age children, want to come on the Fantastic Voyage, we do encourage you to join us. And Tom, give people a little bit of information on how to get on the cruise, can you?
Dr. Fauci, your children are adult age, right?
They are indeed. Thank you.
I mean, because
it's good to be with you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Fauci. We appreciate it.
Righto. Bye-bye.
And doctor, if I can just ask you one more thing, for all of our folks who are subscribing to our What You Need to Know newsletter, and we ask you to do that as well, to go to SybilWilkes.com and subscribe. It's absolutely free, and we do give you information, give you a coronavirus update each and every day in our newsletter. So please do that.
All right. Thank you, Sybil. Thank you, Tom. Appreciate it. Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much, Doctor. It's been a pleasure and an honor. Tom, let's talk about the cruise a little bit. And for people who want to get more information about the cruise.
Okay. We have over 40 performers. 40 performers. The party is right up under your shoes, wherever you are.
Right. Like you said, 24/8.
24/8. And we're raising money to help students stay in school at HBCUs. This will be our 22nd year doing this, and a lot of HBCU alumni and friends attend. And your money is well spent. You'll be entertained, and you're helping to keep the doors open at historically Black colleges and universities. So please book it.
Please go to blackamericaweb.com. You can get more information on that. And Tom, you've done a great job. You look great. And the vaccine has done you well, I can tell.
And the beach.
And the beach.
Yeah, I'm on the beach. Playa.
So you look like you're ready to get back to radio. That's all I'm saying. But we want to thank everybody for joining
us. That's because of the Ernie Barnes picture. I'm not eager to get back.
One more time, go to blackamericaweb.com, as well as you can call. You can do the old-fashioned calling at 214-495-1963. 214-495-1963. Book it today. Get on the cruise. And that 24/8 promise that Tom Joyner makes, he lives up to it each and every year.
And we'll be taking shots, not vaccination shots.
You know the shots.
We'll be taking shots at my office hours. I'm 24/8. I'm at the bar. And building our immune system with tequila.
Absolutely. The agua of life. All right. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining us today. It's great to be back with the Fly Jock, obviously, and to have our very special guest, Dr. Anthony Fauci, America's doctor. Thanks so much. And we will see you next time. But don't forget, blackamericaweb.com, or call and book today for the Tom Joyner Foundation Fantastic Voyage. See you soon.